And pass along their legacy to the next generation. You also got a chance to see our men of Trinity, which are very, very important to us. You saw Ben, Willie, Timmy, and I believe Seth was there as well. So that's a special treat because you don't always see the men of Trinity dancing at every function. Next, we have our beginner dancers. Are you ready to dance, girls? Okay, here they come. Thank you. Galway Gold, and it's a tribute to our first world title back in 1987. Now, Trinity's won a remarkable 17 world titles. And next month, we have 20 of our dancers, both male and female, going to the World Championships of Irish Dance to represent Trinity and the United States. We're very proud of that. And here come our young movers.
Thank you.
done in the last year? Does anyone have a guess? Would you like it? Okay, so I have a guess of 100. Anyone else, sir? Okay, it's actually 460 performances. So, yes. So this team alone has had 16 performances in the last few days. Yes, I believe we did 8 yesterday. And over the 3-day period, Trinity will do 242 performances just in 3 days. So we get a lot of experience that way. And they love connecting with members of the community. That is a lot of fun for them. Returning to our ensemble.
Competitions.
The knots that you're seeing on here, they are inspired by the Bible or the Book of Kells at Trinity College of Dublin. Has anyone seen the Book of Kells? Great, so if you look at the old book, that's where we got our inspiration from. And the colors that you see on her school dress, they are specifically Trinity colors. So anyone worldwide would recognize this as a Trinity costume. Can you spin for us, Molly? So she also has a cape on the back. And then we have Harper and Corinne and Haley and Maeve. They're all wearing solo dresses. So at a point in a dancer's career when they're competing, they earn their solo dress by achieving a certain level. And then they get to choose their solo dress. They get to choose the colors, the style. Oftentimes they're very expensive, so we start by borrowing or purchasing one that has been used by a dancer before. When Maeve purchased hers, she purchased it from a dancer, and every time we're at a fesh or a competition, that dancer comes up and says, "Oh, that's my dress, it's good luck, can I rub the pot of gold?" So she has a pot of gold on her dress. Can you spin? So she has a cape on hers as well that comes off. So the girls will rub the pot of gold for good luck. And whether it's a Trinity dancer or another dancer, it doesn't matter because we're all one Irish dancing family. And Haley has a beautiful velvet dress. Can you spin it for us, Haley? These are Swarovski crystals. So these are really special crystals. So when one falls off, we chase them. We go get them. And now they're like, someone wants a crystal. Because they're really hard to replace. And then Corinne has a beautiful blue gown. Can you spin? Do you see all the crystals on the top? And also she has a small flowered cape on the bottom. So girls, how do you feel when you're wearing these dresses?
I'm very confident in what I do.
That's right. I think that we want our dancers to not only be beautiful dancers, but confident individuals as well. It's very important to develop their sense of character, and that's what part of Irish dancing does. So thank you, ladies.
Thank you.
danced at the Grand Ole Opry a number of times. So that's why it's called the Nashville Reel. So I'm bringing Harper back out here. So Harper and Kerrigan are qualified for the Nationals competition in July. So it's a big deal, as well as...
Thank you.
show, if you'd like, the dancers would like to come around and say hi and greet you and maybe answer any questions that you have. You're welcome to ask me any questions, but you might want to hear it directly from the dancer's mouth. So if you'd like, please talk to them. Maybe they'd like to take some photographs with you if you're willing to do that. Here's our ensemble.